Today's topic is basics of accounts. The students are very much confused with the events and transactions. Then first of all, we must know what is called event. What is called event or events. According to the dictionary meaning, event means all the happenings are called events. But in accountancy, those events will consider as event with which there is a monetary involvement. Without involvement of money, the events are not considered as an event in accounts. For example, the student, when you are coming to the college or to your school, suppose you are coming by walking, then you cannot measure the amount of expenditure what you have spent for coming to the school or college. Then although it is an event, but you cannot measure in terms of money. That's why it is not an event in commerce, in accounts. And the events which can be measured in terms of money, those events are called transactions. Transactions. Then it is very clear that the events which can be measured in terms of money, those are called transactions. Therefore, to be a transaction, all should be a monetary event. And if the monetary event, then it is a transaction. Then it may be clearly said that all events are not transaction, but all transactions are event. Clear? Then we can say all transactions are event, but all events are not transactions. Clear? All transactions are event, because to be a transaction, there must be a monetary change in between the parties involved. Somebody will receive the benefit and somebody will sacrifice that benefit. Either may be in terms of money or in terms of service or goods or services, you can say. But all events are not transactions, because there are some events. Suppose the example what I have already said, that you are coming to the school or college by walking, you cannot measure how much money you have spent for that. Or you like your friend, you like your father, but you cannot measure in terms of money that how much likings you have on your parents or your friends. Therefore, you cannot measure in terms of money. Therefore, those events are not transactions. Clear? Then what is event? What is transaction? I think up to this is clear. Now, the next part, that all transactions should be recorded chronologically in the books of accounts. Therefore, the next thing what comes in accounts is that journal entries. Journal entries. What is journal? If we talk about the journal, if I ask the students that what is journal, the students usually give answer, journal is a book where the day-to-day transactions are recorded. But the point is that it is not a single book. Journal is a conglomeration of some set of books. I am giving you the clear idea about journal, that journal can be divided into two. Number one is special journal, and number two, journal proper. What is special journal? As and when the transactions occur in the business, those transactions are recorded by using any one of the subsidiary books under special journal. Then the point is that what are those subsidiary books? Subsidiary books are now subsidiary books under special journal. Number one, cash book. Number two, purchase day book. Number three, sales day book. Number four, I am lacking some space, therefore I am writing at the top. Number four, purchase return book. Number five, sales return book. Number six, bills receivable book. Number seven, bills payable book. Purchase return book is also called return outward book, and sales return book is also called return inward book. Now, these are the subsidiary books under special journal. Therefore, now we can clearly say that when the transactions occur in the business, those transactions are recorded by using any one of the subsidiary books under special journal. Then again, from the beginning, I am making it clear. Please try to understand. Number one, I told you, cash book. Then what is cash book? When the cash transactions are occurred in the business, only those cash transactions should be recorded in the cash book. But the credit transactions cannot be recorded in the cash book. And specifically, the student should keep in mind the capital expenditure or revenue expenditure. That segregation we should not do in cash book. In cash book, all cash transactions will come. Either goods purchased or machinery purchased or revenue income or capital income. Clear. But cash book, how many types? Cash book may be, number one, single column cash book. Number two, double column cash book. Number three, triple column cash book. Number four, multiple column cash book. This is, you note down, multiple column cash book. In maximum books, up to these have been given, single column, double column and triple column, but multiple column they have not mentioned. Suppose from different heads you are getting your money and for the different purposes you are paying that money, in that case the multiple column you can make on the left side and on the right side, that is on the debit side and the credit side, and a total column on both the sides to get the closing balance of cash. And another cash book is petty cash book. Petty cash book. For the petty cashier, the cashier who are keeping records of a small amount, then they use petty cash book. And that is another
impress system of petty cash, that is another system, a particular amount the petty cashier keep in their hands as a deposit money at the beginning of a particular period. That is impress system of petty cash book. We'll discuss it later in detail. But right now, cash book, again I'm making it short, all cash transactions should be recorded in cash book without considering capital or revenue. All incomes and all payments should be recorded in cash book, either in single column or in double column or in triple column or in multiple column or in the petty cash book. Clear? Now, second one is number two, purchase day book. Purchase day book. The students, they have misconception or they are very much confused with the entries which will be passed through purchase day book. The student should keep in mind only the goods, not the assets. Only the goods or services which have been purchased on credit, those will be recorded in the purchase day book. If assets are purchased, those will come under journal proper, not here. That should be recorded separately. And students are very much confused with that. Suppose the goods purchased on credit from Mr. X. Suppose the goods have been purchased on credit from Mr. X. Then entry will pass purchase account debit to Mr. X account as a creditor. But if Mr. X, machinery has been purchased on credit, then what will be entry? Then machinery account debit to, you please try to understand the difference. If the goods or services are purchased, then purchase account debit and X account credit. If the machinery is purchased, then machinery account debit to Mr. X for machinery account. These two are different. These two are very much different. Here only the creditor account be credited for goods, and here the creditor account has been credited for asset. This will come under journal proper, and this will come under special journal. This should be clearly kept in mind of the students. Again, I'm telling you, only the goods purchased on credit will come under purchase day book. And if the assets are purchased on credit, that will go on the other side, under journal proper. And now, next one will come, number three, sales day book. Similarly, in the sales day book, if the goods or services are sold on credit, those will be recorded in sales day book. And here, again the asset are sold on credit, those will be recorded under journal proper. Again, example I'm giving you, suppose the goods have been sold on credit, then the customer account will be debited. That is, debtor account debit to sales account. Suppose Mr. X account debit to sales account. But if the machinery is sold to Mr. X on credit, then entry will be Mr. X for machinery account debit to machinery account. Machine has gone out. That's why machinery account credit. The thing is that difference is here. Here the Mr. X is already debtor. But here Mr. X is a debtor for selling of asset on credit. Mr. X account debit for machinery and machine has gone out. And in both the cases, in purchase day book and sales day book, in both the cases, when purchase return book, we are talking about similarly only the goods which have been purchased on credit, that will be when we are returned, those will be recorded here. And in case of sales return book, when the goods have been sold on credit and the goods have been returned by the customers, those will be recorded in sales return book. This is also called return inward book, and this is called return outward book. And next one, bills receivable book and bills payable book. When the customer is requesting that he does not have right now money and he wants to accept a bill of exchange in the place of giving cash for purchasing of goods, in that case the seller may allow the purchaser to make a bill and the seller may receive that bill from the party concerned. In that case, drawer, drawee and payee, three types of parties may be arises in case of bill of exchange, and this will be discussed separately, bills receivable and bills payable book. Now, under special journal, we are talking about all these subdivisions, and when the transactions occur in the business, those transactions are recorded by using any one of the subsidiary books under special journal. And what is journal proper? Now, journal proper, the transactions which are not recorded in any one of the subsidiary books under special journal, those are recorded in journal proper. And what are those transactions? Number one, opening entries. Number two, closing entries. Three, adjustment entries. Number four, rectification entries. Number five, transfer entries. And number six, entries relating to the credit purchase and sales of assets and stationary items, or we can say in short, residual entries. Under journal proper, again I am telling you, what is journal proper? The transactions which are not recorded in any one of the subsidiary books under special journal, those transactions are recorded under journal proper. And the subdivisions under general proper are number 1 opening entries, number 2 closing entries, number 3 adjustment entries, number 4 rectification entries, number 5 transfer entries, number 6 entries relating to the credit purchase and sales of assets and stationary items, or we can say in short residual entries. We'll have to discuss all these things separately, and I think these are the pillars of the basics of accounts. Without understanding properly all these things separately, one cannot understand accountancy well. And if you want to have your scientific knowledge on accountancy, you must have to make all these things very much clear. Already I have made you clear the subsidiary books under special journal, and I will take a separate class on all these items under general proper. Thank you.